Thank you. audience participation. Is there anyone in the audience today? We need one male or one female contestant who would like to stick their own personal nose onto this stinking foot replica which we have provided for your edification. Can we have a little light in front row? See if there is a chump down there that actually wants it. Hey, the guy in the orange jacket is falling. All right. What do you think, Don? Any good? Not bad, huh? How about a girl? Do we have a girl that likes them? We need to have a girl who will kiss the large toe on the reeking blue foot. Wait a minute. This is a good excuse to get your butt off of the ice cube. There's a girl right there. She's being volunteered for the experiment. What is your name? From America with love, Linda has actually stuck her mouth on this plaster replica of a reeking imported foot. Now, actually, I got this from the Doobie Brothers, actually. This is the left foot of the Doobie Brothers road manager that you just kissed. So you don't have to worry, it's from San Francisco. It's a very psychedelic sort of foot. Now wait a minute. Here, Fido, bring the slippers, little puppy. You wouldn't believe that because it's pink and fluffy, there's little blue ribbons on it and stuff, you wouldn't believe that this was a real dog. Because not many of you in this city have seen pink dogs before. But where I come from, a lot of people have pink dogs, and I want to assure you, and you know I never lie, that this dog is actually alive. This is a bionic poodle. Favorite dogs. Now, I asked this dog a moment ago to bring me the slippers, and this dog did not comply. I'm going to give this dog several chances to explain itself unto me. This is the dog's first chance, and you will be my witnesses here at the Ice Palace. Fido, why did you not bring me the slippers? And the dog said, not good enough, because merely saying and not producing a slipper to a large person is tantamount to, well, what shall we say? He's shining me on. Fido, where's the fucking slipper? Alright, I'm gonna tell you, because this dog is my friend, we do spend a lot of time together, I've learned to understand what he says when he speaks to me. And it's not just a matter that I'm a lonely rock and roll musician and have to resort to the fantasy of thinking that I know what this dog is talking about. No. I really know what's going on inside of this dog's mind. Me and this dog are just like this, you know what I mean? And this dog has just said to me, Frank, go fuck yourself. I'm not going to bring you the slippers. And you know what I have to do to him? See, this dog likes to tease me a lot, you know? It's a spirited little pooch. And so every night when he says that to me, I have to give him the works. And so, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The dog gets the works, part one. Okay, dog. Step number one. show, I'm going to give this dog to a Canadian contractor. Because if you think this dog is ill, the people that built that little Olympic gym for you are really sick!
Because it was a very long time ago, you see.
So she turns to the man and she says, "Hey, buddy, why don't you go out and get a job?" And the man, being a jerk, got up off his little booty and left the Garden of Eden and went out and got a job. And had a wonderful time earning his $1.98 an hour. And brought this money back to the Pooh Man, who purportedly used it for a worthy cause.
Call me?
Hey.
Oh, no.
Why didn't you try?
Why didn't you try?
Oh, shit!
looked over at me with a glazed eye and some bovine perspiration on her upper lip area, and she said, now listen, just get your wasted, then you're halfway there. My body's torn, then my body won't care. I rubbed my chinny chin chin and said, bye bye bye. What sort of thing might this lady get fired upon? The $40 bill didn't matter no more. When her sister got naked and laid on the floor, she said, time to move, old man, we're in the bed. Took me to use a little hoop if I wasn't done yet. I told her, just because the sun was gonna blaze in the sky, no reason to assume I would give her a try. So I pulled on her hair, put her legs up in the air, and I asked her if she had any cooties in there.
What do you mean, cooties? No cooties for me!
She was buns up kneeling, I was wheeling and kneeling.
Right along.